Elizabeth Smart has detailed how becoming a parent has changed the way she reflects on her past abduction, giving her more compassion for her own mother and leaving her convinced she would rather be kidnapped again than seeing her children get hurt. The kidnapping survivor, activist, and author, told Hello Giggles in a new interview that she and her mother, Lois Smart, 60, rarely discuss her 2002 abduction, during which she was kidnapped from her bedroom in Salt Lake City, Utah, marking the beginning of her horrific 9-month captivity. But while working on her new book, Where's There's Hope, Smart decided to interview her mother, and wanted to delve deeper into the topic than they have in the past. Considering the events from her mother's perspective was difficult, Smart said, because she now has 2 children of her own, making her more aware of what her parents went through when she was taken. Smart has an 11-month-old son, James, and a 2-year-old daughter, Chloe, with her husband, Matthew Gilmore, a native of Aberdeen, Scotland, whom she met while on a Latter-day Saints mission in France. Before, when my mother and I would talk, I mean, what happened to me isn't something that comes up in everyday conversation, it's like, every once in a great while, we'll touch on it, Smart said. And so when I sat down to talk to her and listen to what she experienced, having children of my own helped give me greater compassion and understanding of what exactly she went through. I look at my own little children and I think, if anything ever happened to them, I mean, I would rather go through it for them. I'd rather do anything for them than ever have them hurt. I'd rather be kidnapped 5 times before ever allowing it to happen to them. I had a greater understanding and a greater compassion and a greater empathy for what she went through than I have in previous conversations. Smart also explained why it was important to her to name her captors, Brian David Mitchell and Wanda Barzi, who are both currently behind bars, instead of calling them by a generic denomination such as my captors. I'm not gonna say it's the same for everyone, but for me, those are their names. That's who they are, she said. They don't come up in everyday conversation, it's not like I talk about them like they're my friends. But continually referring to them only as my captors or my tormentors still gives them that power of being my captors, of being my tormentors. That's still granting them that power over my life, and I just refuse to do that. Smart, a survivor of assault who testified during Mitchell's trial that he raped her daily during her captivity, expressed her support for the hashtag MeToo movement against sexual violence. I'm so happy that this movement is happening, she said. I think that it's been a long time coming, and we've got daily proof in the media of how long this has been going on, and how high up it goes. And this has been going on forever and it's penetrated all levels of society. This movement is needed. Having survivors coming forward and talking about it isn't only making this issue real for themselves, but it's also setting this precedent. It is now okay to admit that something has happened to you. It's okay to admit that you were raped. And there are other people out there who are your, I guess, let's say, comrades in arms. You're not alone. This is especially important, she said, because victims of sexual violence are often exposed to threats from their abusers, who tell them no one, not even their parents, will believe them if they speak out. It's an extremely isolating crime, and so it's terrifying coming forward. Those threats from your rapist or your abuser seem very, very real, Smart added. But to see this sort of avalanche, this tidal wave of survivors coming forward and saying, this isn't okay, and this did happen to me, and this happened to me, and this happened to me. I think people for the first time are realizing, people will believe me. And it's okay. I can admit this. In her new book, which follows her 2013 memoir, My Story, Smart explores the topic of how to cope with trauma, highlighting grief, sadness, and anger as necessary emotions. Asked what she would tell others dealing with trauma, Smart said, I would tell them, if you're sad or if you're angry or if you're dealing with negative feelings, that, first of all, it's okay to feel anger. It's okay to feel grief. It's okay to feel sadness. Those are natural emotions to victims. It's not your fault.
Tell me where the freak's at.